Hello everyone. My name is Boson Amadenu Senyefia. I am a mathematics teacher to undergraduate and diploma students of a college of education in Ghana. I'm going to take you through a lesson as to how you can let students or pupils derive the generalization for finding the area of a right angle triangle through a set of activities where they would be able to understand that the math that they see is just part of everyday life activity, and the formulas are not just there and that they have to use at all costs, but it came out of a meaning. So the objective for this lesson is to be able to derive the generalization for finding the area of a right angle triangle through practical activity. We'll make use of certain materials. We'll have a geoboard. This is a 9x9 geoboard. And you can see a set of pins or nails. Each pair is 1 centimeter apart. So this is what? This square, small square here, is actually a 1 centimeter square of area, right? Okay. So before we start, we are going to write certain headings on our paper. We have a paper and a pen to put our recordings down. So I'm writing the base, and then I'm also writing the height. So we are going to use a certain base and a certain height on the geoboard to be able to find the area practically. So we start with the smallest unit, which is 1. So we want to form a right angle triangle of base 1 unit and of height 1 unit. So I'm going to, I had to fold the rubber band because I needed a smaller and a more tightened kind of. So look at it. So already we have seen that the space between each pair of nails is just 1 centimeter. So this square, small square we have here is what? A unit square, right? So we have 1 by 1. This square has 1 by 1, dimension. So we have 1 centimeter square as area. But when we use the rubber band to form a right angle triangle of height 1 centimeter and 1 centimeter and base 1 centimeter, what will be the area for that right angle triangle? Remember, the area for this square we have here is 1 centimeter square. And we realize that the rubber band, the right angle triangle actually takes half of that area. Okay, so we can see that what? The full set of area will be what? 1 centimeter square, but the area we have formed here with this right angle triangle is just half of that. So I'm going to record 1/2 centimeter squared as the area formed by the dimensions of 1 centimeter of a height and 1 centimeter of a base of a right angle triangle. So the area is 1/2 centimeter squared I'm recording, when the height was 1 centimeter and the base was 1 centimeter. Okay. So we need a series of them. So to form the next right angle triangle, I'm actually going to make the height, or increase the height by 1 centimeter, and then the base also by 1 centimeter. So the question now is, what will be the area of a right angle triangle of base 2 centimeters and height also 2 centimeters? So let's find out. We have a full 1 centimeter square unit here, and we have 2 halves. So what will be the total area of this right angle triangle? I'm suggesting you are thinking 1 centimeter squared plus half, right? Yes, so that will give us what? 2 centimeters squared. So I'm recording 2 centimeters and the height was 2 centimeters. We had the area to be what? 2 centimeters squared. So I'm now going to form a third right angle triangle, and I would just want to increase the height by 1 unit. That's 1 centimeters, and then base also by 1 centimeters. Now let us also record the area formed. So how many of the 1 centimeter squared do we have? 1, 2, 3, okay? And then how many of the halves? 1, 2, 3. So that'll give us 4.5 centimeter squared. So when the base was 3 centimeters and the height was 3 centimeters, the area was 4.5 centimeters. Let's do one more, then we'll look at the generalization that we can form. So I'm increasing the height by 1 centimeter and then the base also by 1 centimeter. There we go. So let's find the area. What would it be now? Let's count the full ones first. 1, 2 centimeters, okay. So 3 centimeters, 4 centimeters, 5 centimeters, 6 centimeters. And then the halves are 1, 2, 3, 4. So that'll give us what? 8 centimeters squared. So when the base was 4 centimeters and the height was 4 centimeters, the area was 8 centimeters squared. Okay, so I'll put this down. Now, all the students need to do is to now look at their results and then try to form a generalization out of it through brainstorming. So they would be thinking that, what is the connection between the base, the height, and the area? So they will come out with their, after brainstorming, they will come out with a generalization. If they are finding it difficult, you can probe them to actually see the link. Okay, so we see that base is 1 centimeter and then the height is 1 centimeter. And 1 by 1 is 1. But the moment we divide by 2, we will get the half. 2 times 2 is what? 4. But the area was 2. So of course, 4 divided by 2 will give you 2. 3 by 3 is 9. And what do we do to the 9 to get 4.5? We divide it by 2. 4 by 4 is 16. And what do we do to the 16 to get 8? It's when we divide by 2. So they realize that this trend, this trend unfolds more and more as you continue with the process. So with this, they'll get a generalization that to find the area of a right angle triangle, you need to multiply the base by the height and divide your answer by 2. So with this, they would be able to love the mathematics they do and see that it is they learnt it with meaning. After they've seen the generalization, they don't need to be going through this process again whenever they meet a right angle triangle. They can now use the generalization, but the most important thing is that they learn math with meaning, so that wherever they get the opportunity, they can explain to any student or pupil at any level how the idea came about. I hope you've enjoyed this lesson. Have a nice day.